democracy, quite frankly. So during that period of time, I want to ask you about two specific, if we have enough time. First, the Trump Tower. So you were negotiating for this. As you said, it was to be the tallest building in Europe. In your guilty plea with the special counsel, you quote, say, it quotes, Cohen asked individual one, is that President Trump?
Yes.
Okay. About the possibility of President Trump traveling to Russia in connection with the Moscow project, and asked a senior campaign official about potential business travel to Russia. When did this conversation happen, do you recall?
Early on in the campaign.
And who was the campaign official?
Corey Lewandowski.
What did you discuss in this meeting?
Possibility of which dates that Mr. Trump would have availability if, in fact, that we were going to go over to Russia to take a look at the project. I'm sorry, sir?
So, go ahead.
Unfortunately, it never came to fruition because we were never successful in getting the first prong of what I needed, which was ownership or control over a piece of property. And until such time, there was no reason to come up with a date. But when I first received the information request to go to Russia, what I decided to do is spoke to Mr. Trump about it. He told me to speak to Corey and see what dates might be available if I got the information I needed.
So it stopped because of appearances, or did it stop because the parties decided not to pursue it?
I'm so sorry, I don't understand your question.
So why did the pursuit of the Trump Tower that Mr. Trump has now said, of course he pursued it because he thought he might be going back into the development business, why was the reason that the deal stopped?
Because he won the presidency.
Okay. So in that interim period of time, you must admit it looks troubling that now that we know what foreign influence was attempting to do, whether there was collusion or not, it certainly appears troubling that Mr. Trump was part of this negotiation, and at the same time, what we know, perhaps separately, that the Russians were engaged in our election.
Well, I don't know about them being engaged in the election. I can only talk for myself. Here I would say to Mr. Trump, in response to his question, what's going on with Russia, is I'm still waiting for documents, and then that night at a rally, he would turn around and do his battle cry of no Russia, no collusion, no involvement, witch hunt.
Okay, on a separate subject, but somewhat related, on January 17 of this year, the Wall Street Journal published a story stating that you hired John Gager, the owner of a consulting company who works for Liberty University in Virginia, to rig at least two online polls related to Donald Trump. Did you hire him?
Those were back in, I believe, 2014.
So you did hire him?
Yes, I spoke with Mr. Gager about manipulating these online polls.
And did he use bots to manipulate the poll?
He used algorithms, and if that includes bots, then the answer is yes.
Yes, that's accurate. Did the president have any involvement?
Yes.
In directing you to do this?
Yes.
What were the results of the poll?
Exactly where we wanted them to be. In the CNBC poll, we came in at number 9, and the Drudge Report, he was top of the Drudge Report as well.
Okay.
Poll.
And just
please understand also, the CNBC poll was called The Contenders, and it was the top 250 people that they named, and it was supposed to be the top 10 most influential people.
Let me just finish with earlier today.